Good morning and welcome to the service of Thanksgiving, the fourth Sunday after Pentecost, or the third Sunday after Trinity, and also known in the secular world as Father's Day, giving thanks to Almighty God for fatherhood. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God, for from him and through him and to him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. We begin our Mass on page 101 in our Mass books. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed Lord and Father, we have assembled in your name and in fellowship with one another. Enable us by your grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, to proclaim and respond to your holy word. Teach us to pray for your world and your church. Grant that we, confessing our sins, may worthily offer to you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice, and eat and drink of your spiritual food in this holy sacrament. Amen. The Collect for Purity. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord of mercy,
Christ of mercy,
Lord have mercy.
Glory
to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our collects may be found on page 3 in our bulletins, or it may be found on page 174 in our prayer books, proper 7. Following that, we'll have the Collect for Father's Day and the Darsen theme collect, Reigniting True Worship. Let us pray. O God, our defender, storms rage about us and cause us to be afraid. Rescue your people from despair. Deliver your sons and daughters from fear, and preserve us all from unbelief. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, you entrusted your Son, Jesus, the child of Mary, to the care of Joseph, an earthly father. Bless all fathers as they care for their families. Give them strength and wisdom, tenderness and patience. Support them in the work that they have to do. Protect them as they look to you for love and salvation. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Together we pray. O God, our Father, you are great, and above you there is no other. We, your children, humble ourselves before you. We turn from selfishness, pride, and apathy, and we earnestly seek your face. Bless, strengthen, and renew your church. Reignite our desire to worship you and you alone. Forgive us for those times when we have wounded you and wounded others. May your Holy Spirit strengthen us to achieve great things this year through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel, chapter 17, verses 32 to 49. 1 Samuel chapter 17, 32 to 49. David said to Saul, "Let no one's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with this Philistine." Saul said to David, "You are not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for you are just a boy, and he has been a warrior from his youth." But David said to Saul, "Your servant used to keep sheep for his father, and whenever a lion or a bear came and took a lamb from the flock, I went after it and struck it down, rescuing the lamb from its mouth. And if it turned against me, I would catch it by the jaw, strike it down, and kill it. Your servant has killed both lions and bears, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be like one of them, since he has defied the armies of the living God." David said, "The Lord who saved me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear will save me from the hand of this Philistine." So Saul said to David, "Go, and may the Lord be with you." Saul clothed David with his armor. He put a bronze helmet on his head and clothed him with a coat of mail. David strapped Saul's sword over the armor and tried in vain to walk, for he was not used to them. Then David said to Saul, "I cannot walk with these, for I am not used to them." So David removed them. Then he took his staff in his hand and chose five smooth stones from the wadi and put them in the shepherd's bag, in the pouch. His sling was in his hand, and he drew near to the Philistine. The Philistine came on and drew near to David with his shield bearer in front of him. When the Philistine looked at and saw David, he disdained him, for he was only a youth, ruddy and handsome in appearance. The Philistine said to David, "Am I a dog that you come to me with sticks?" And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. And the Philistine said to David, "Come to me, and I will give your flesh to the birds of the air and to the wild animals of the field." But David said to the Philistine, "You come to me with sword, spear, and javelin, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This very day the Lord will deliver you into my hand, and I will strike you down and cut off your head, and I will give the dead bodies of the Philistine army this very day to the birds of the air and to the wild animals of the earth, so that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel, that all this assembly may know that the Lord does not save by sword and spear. For the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hand." Then the Philistine drew nearer to meet David. David ran quickly toward the battle line to meet the Philistine. David put his hand in his bag, took out a stone, slung it, and struck the Philistine on his forehead. The stone sank into his forehead, and he fell face down to the ground. The word of the Lord.
The appointed psalm for this morning is Psalms 133, found on page 648 of the Book of Common Prayer, or pages 4 in the bulletin. Oh, how good and pleasant it is when brethren live together in unity.
It's like fine oil upon the head that runs down upon the beard.
Upon the bread of Aaron and runs down upon the collar of his robe.
It is like the dew of Hermon that falls upon the hills of Zion.
For the Lord has ordained the blessing, life forevermore. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Second reading is taken from Corinthians chapter 6, verses 1 through 13. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 1 through 13. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, at an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See now in the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God. With the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see, we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, as poor, yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing everything. We have spoken frankly to you, Corinthians. Our heart is wide open to you. There's no restriction in our affliction, our affections, but only in yours. In return, I speak as to children. Open wide your hearts also. The word of the Lord.
A gradual hymn, 499. 499. Dear Lord and Father of mankind.
Thank you.
give our fullness ways. Reclothe us in our rightful mind, in pure life thyself.
Be with you.
A reading of the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. When evening had come, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. And a great storm of wind arose, And the waves beat into the boat so that the boat was already filling. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care if we perish?" And he awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. He said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you no faith?" And they were filled with awe and said to one another, "Who then is this that even wind and sea obey him?" The Gospel of Christ.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Keep calm. Jesus is in the boat. Keep calm. Jesus is in the boat. Be still, my soul, for God is on my side. Oh, really? You don't know what's going on, though, do you? My life is a wreck. My finances are a free fall. My health, oh, don't get me started now. It's just one thing after another. First is this and then is that. I get this to fix and then something else goes wrong. Relationship gone wrong too. Loneliness, despair, depression. Well then, there's what's going on in the news. A shooting last night. Not only in Nassau Village, not in Grantstown, not in Kent Road, not even in Nassau, but now in the Family Islands, which was clean, pristine, serene, and peaceful. I had hoped to retire there one day, but now innocent people are killed. I just do not know. And you say, be calm, put God in the boat. If the boat break, He will allow me to float. Where is this God? Asleep at the wheel? Doesn't he watch over his people? Doesn't he watch over me? And you're telling me to sing, "Be still, my soul." Come on. Come on. Be real. Well, yes. Let's get real. Because it would be just wishful thinking if we had no bias, no basis for singing, Be still, my soul, for God is on my side. That would just be small talk, whisking past the graveyard, if there was nothing more to it than that. But dear friends, I want to tell you today that there's a real basis for us to say to our soul, be still. Men, this is our day. Be still. Still your soul today. Why? We have someone who says to the storms of our life, even to the real physical storms, peace, be still. And so I am keeping it real when I say to you, keep calm. Jesus is in the boat. Our text in the Holy Gospel for today from St. Mark's Gospel, chapter 4, Jesus calming the sea being referred to as the Sea of Galilee. I understand, though, that it's really more like a big lake. It's fairly large for a lake, but it's not what you would think as a sea. However, because of its location, situated in the Rift Valley, where the winds come down from Mount Hermon and sweep across the water, whipping up the waves in hurrying, yes, the Sea of Galilee came and act like a sea with a storm whip up all of a sudden. So here are the disciples in a boat. And keep in mind, many of them are experienced fishermen who know these waters better than anyone. And even them, they are panicking. It's night, it's dark, and the winds and the waves are too much for them. The storm is starting to fill the boat with water. Well, will they make it? Or will this be the end for them? But wait. They remember who's in the boat with them. It's Jesus, their master, their teacher. And what have they seen Jesus do up to this point? They have seen Jesus heal diseases and cast out demons. He seems to have an inside track with God. However, yeah, maybe he can help. So let's ask him. What's this? Oh, he's sleeping. Here we are, about to drown, and he is sleeping. Look at him, lying there on the cushion. Let's wake him up. Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? The disciples have known their master to be a caring man of God, willing and able to help people in need. So this just doesn't make any sense that we should sleep, that he should sleep right through this urgent crisis, and he would not care about and do nothing about it and their distress. Do you ever feel like these disciples? Like, where's God in this? Doesn't he know what I am going through? Why doesn't he do something about it? He's got the power. I know he loves me. At least I think he does. So why? Why is he letting me suffer like this? Don't you care, Lord? That was how the disciples felt. And once Jesus wakes up, he shows that he really does care and that he's not going to let them perish. He rebukes the wind and says to the sea, peace, be still. And it was so. And evening and morning were the That's a creation account, isn't it? God speaks and it is so. And that's the point, isn't it? Jesus here is demonstrating authority over nature itself, over the created order, and only God can do that. He is the God-man. He is the incarnate man. And Jesus exercised this power in connection with his care. He has care and concern for his followers, and he has the power and authority to do something about it on their behalf. This is comforting. This is encouraging. Know this today. Jesus is not going to let you perish. You will not perish eternally. Rather, you will live. You will live forever because Christ is exercising his authority on your behalf. He speaks and you are saved. He speaks to the wind and the waves, peace, be still. And they are at peace. They do become still. The word of the Lord makes things happen. You may not have their experience, but you have some experience of being in crisis, haven't you? A hard place where you felt trapped. You have other dangers you face, both physical and mental threats to both body and soul, illness, disease, disability, danger on the highways, yes, afflictions, hardships, calamity. And hear what Paul says. It's the human condition in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 18 to 21. I have been in prison more times than they. I was given 39 lashes by the Jews. 3 times I was whipped by the Romans. Once I was stoned. I have been in 3 shipwrecks. And once I spent 24 hours in the water, in danger from flood, in danger from robberies, in danger from my own people. Yet he learned to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. He was convicted that God would take care of him, that he went to death by the sword because he believed that God will take care of him. He believed that there was victory with God and God fought the battle for him. And there, one thing we all face one day, later, now or later, death will come one day to me, to you, to us. It has a way of touching all of us. First, indirectly, as we mourn for the loss of a loved one and see ourselves surrounded by death. And eventually, the grim reaper who will come calling our name, and how are we going to get out of that? How? It's because Jesus is in the boat with us. It may seem for a moment like Jesus is sleeping and that he does not care. Husbands feel that the wife is not checking sometimes. Hello? The wife feels that sometimes she chose the wrong man. And the children get her crying, I didn't ask to be here, so put up with me. You'll never hear anything like that. For the moment, it may feel that way. But rest assured, when those waves come so hard and so close that you feel like there is no hope, there is still hope. Jesus will speak to all the threats that threaten to overwhelm you. Jesus, your Lord and Savior, will say to the devil's accusation and to death that would swallow you up, Jesus will speak his authority, his words, and say, peace, be still. Jesus will say, shut up, devil. You have no room to talk. My shedded blood on the cross for the sins of the world is there. they are washed away and forgiven. Jesus will say, be muzzled, death. My resurrection has turned the table on you. You will not have that one. She is baptized. You will not have him either. He is one of mine. They will live forever in my kingdom. And when we continue to look at the story, we see where the wind ceased and there was a great calm. And yet, there's another calm still to be bestowed. It is the calm that Jesus will give to his disciples. Because right now, they don't know what to make of this. If the storm distressed them, this power displayed by Jesus absolutely astonished them. Why are you afraid, he says. Why are you scared? Have you still no faith? And they were filled with great fear and said to one another, who then is this that even the wind and the sea obey him? The disciples are realizing that they are in the presence of one whose power goes far beyond anything they have witnessed before. Who is this man? He commands the wind and the waves. Who can do this? Now, we have come to the bottom line of this story. It's about Jesus. Oh, it's Jesus. It's Jesus in the boat. Your boat, my boat, our boat. How well do you know Jesus today? The more time the disciples spent with Jesus, the more they see him do, the more they hear him speak, the more they realize this is no ordinary rabbi. The realization is beginning to dawn in them and grow up in them. Who this man might be? Could he be the Messiah? Is he the Christ? Jesus is revealing himself to be just that. Jesus is in the boat of your life always. No matter what happens, he is in your boat. He's not just a gratified king. He is your Savior, sent by God to sit in your boat and to bail out your water and bring you to shore. This is the only way to receive true peace, peace with God, so that we can safely make it to our harbor. Here is Jesus, the very Son of Man, the Son of God, the Word of God, by whom all things were made. And he does this suffering and this dying for you and for me. He will never let you perish. He loves you so much. He will go to the limit for you. He is in your boat. He will help you when you're in trouble to float. Be still. They will discover even more about Jesus. They will learn what kind of Messiah he is. The King who suffered for their sins to do the Father's will, who sent him to the world for us. Now, friends, this morning, it doesn't make sense by the world's standard, but it does make sense by God's standard. Here is one who can command the waves, and yet he willingly goes to the cross to suffer and to die. Why? Why, when he has all power, he doesn't have to do it? Why he decides to humble himself, to empty himself? Why? Because This is the way, the only way, that the storms of life and death can be stilled. This is the way, the only way, the storms of life can be stilled. This is the only way that we can receive true peace with God, so that we can safely make it to our harbor. Here is Jesus, the very Son of God, the Word of God, by whom all things were made. And this is how you can keep calm when all about you is storming and howling, because Jesus is in your boat. He will not let you perish. Things may look bad for the moment, but the big picture of things, you know you're going to make it. You are going to make it, church. You are going to make it, men. You are going to make it, women. You are going to make it because Christ is in the boat. And he will help you through the stormy seas to float. And so, keep calm. Jesus is in the boat. Let's pause for a few moments and let's listen to the final stanza of Be Still and Know. Still, my soul, for God is on your side. In his name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Stand now and affirm our faith in God in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
Intercessions, Form F, found on page 115 in your Books of Common Prayer. Let us pray for the church and for all people according to their needs. Lord, in your love, bless and inspire members of the clergy, especially Howard, our Archbishop, Leish, our bishop, Drexel and Gilbert, our assistant bishops, Kingsley, our priest, Desiree, our deacon, and John, our ordinand. Guide and direct all heads of state and all who bear rule, especially those in this land. Cornelius, our Governor General, Hubert, our Prime Minister, Philip, the leader of the opposition, all members of Parliament, and all persons serving in local government. Reveal the common good to those in positions of public trust and to decision makers in industry and commerce. Enlighten with your spirit all places of education and learning. Comfort and help all persons who are in any trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, especially those of this parish and those of this nation. Remember our brothers and sisters, especially all the members of this world, and all persons who have died in your faith and fear. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the witness of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, for the holy patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and all the saints who have been good examples in their several generations.
And finally, let us pray for our needs and those of others.
Accept our prayers and
intercessions, Father, according to your wisdom,
for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us therefore confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand for the peace. We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Our offertory hymn 412, 412, Faith of Our Fathers.
Thank you.
gift which you have given us. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. For in the mystery of your Godhead, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you have revealed your glory, three persons, equal in majesty, undivided in splendor, yet one Lord, one God, ever to be worshipped and glorified. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Eucharistic prayer B, found on page 135. Page 135, Eucharistic prayer form B. Holy and gracious Father, all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, whom you sent to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to the God and Father of all. We therefore bring you these gifts, and we ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who offered himself in obedience to your will, the perfect sacrifice for all mankind. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it for the remembrance of me." Let us say the third acclamation prayer found in our prayer books. Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Father, calling to mind the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension, his continual intercession for us in heaven, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering, and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may be filled with your Holy Spirit and become one body in Christ and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. May he make us a perpetual offering to you and enable us in communion with Blessed Mary, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, Blessed John the Baptist, our patron, blessed Peter, blessed Paul, blessed James, and the whole company of heaven, to share in the inheritance of your saints. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in sounds of everlasting praise. And now, as our Savior Christ hath commanded and taught us, we are bold to say as we pray, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Lamb of God, the gifts of God for the people of God. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come to my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come to my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come to my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. Turn now to page 147. We pray together, page 147. Almighty Father, we thank you for feeding us the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May we who share his body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We upon whom your Spirit shines give light to the world. Help us continue in faithful witness to your word, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest, preserve, and keep you this day and forevermore.
Amen. Go in peace, the love, and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
How's everyone this morning? Okay, this is a special day for some of us, probably most of us. The church is clouded with men today. And that is so wonderful to see and experience. But before we pour a blessing upon the men of the congregation, are there any persons celebrating a birthday or an anniversary today or during the week? You may stand where you are. We say a little prayer for you and then a prayer for the men. And I would come to the aisles and sprinkle the men with holy water. So is there any person celebrating birthdays, anniversaries? Please stand where you are. One. Okay, let's bow our heads in prayer, giving thanks to Almighty God for his many blessings upon this, his servant. O God, look down upon this, your servant, as she stands before you, seeking your blessing and seeking your help as she celebrates her natal anniversary. We thank you for her. We pray, Lord, you may put a hedge of protection around her to give her the strength and courage when she feels weak, that she may have confidence in your loving care and always have an attitude of gratitude to show appreciation for your love, your power, and your grace. Touch her now at the very core of her being and give her, O God, that added strength she needs to go on from day to day to be your humble servant, recognizing always that you are in her boat this day and evermore. Amen. Recognize fathers, biological or otherwise, and it's good when we can come into the church and give thanks to Almighty God for what he has done and continues to do within our lives. In a sense of appreciation, we have our supportive arms who are here, children, wife, mothers, and guardians who are here to show that support and encouragement to us. So I'm going to ask all the men in the congregation to stand at this point. All men, stand please where you are. This is so wonderful. Oh my goodness. Now, would you give them a round of applause before I pray? This is a very memorable and touching day in my life. This is the day when my oldest brother passed on his eternal reward. So I could never forget this day. Let us pray. O God, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, in a human family, to make us conscious of what it means to be family. Right now, loving Master, as we come before you as fathers, as men, within your household, we pray, loving Master, that you may help us to be that icon, that image that was portrayed by Joseph to the Blessed Virgin Mary, but to your Son, Jesus Christ, that we may be that image and that example to help others to find you mighty to save. We thank you, Lord, for fatherhood. We thank you for the rearing of children. And we pray, Lord, that you may support us all the day long from this troublous life, until the shades lengthen and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over and our work is done, and we may always be conscious that you are in our boat. These things we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We continue to pray for the work of our church, the work that's wrought with us as family persons. We pray for families, and today we give thanks for the little nursery that's here started here. Elizabeth, give her a round of applause for taking care of the children. So parents, if you want to bring your children to the first service, Elizabeth has volunteered to take care of them until time for the blessing. So we thank her and we thank all of you. If you would like to, if you want to keep them to yourself, it's all right, but if you wish them to be pacified when necessary, Elizabeth Taylor is here to help. We appreciate that very much. Okay. we look in our bulletins, it indicates all the thanksgiving that persons have made for your support in the event of death and sickness, so please take note of that. Condolences are extended to Joanne Wilson and family on the death of her husband, Dane Wilson, who died on Thursday the 10th. The Requiem Mass will be held for him on the 25th of June, so take note of that. And also another Requiem Mass will be held for Francina Ramming on Saturday the 3rd of July, 2021. We continue to do ministry within our church. The CYM meets regularly on Friday. Bible study continues, so please get engaged in Bible study. as much as you can so you would know the Lord better and you would be able to stand firmer with him. Let's continue to pray for the sick, the suffering, the sorrowful among us, and the dying. We pray for those who have gone on to their eternal reward. Upon their souls and upon our Christian souls, may sweet Jesus have mercy. Because we can't really have a reception for the men, but the ACW, I think, and the usher have a treat for us, so you can get your treat as you leave the church today. God bless us, and let's have a very wonderful day. And I know we'll be treated very well. I don't know why they say crab and rice. Why do they say that? I never understood that. Maybe you could tell me why you got to have crab and rice on Father's Day. Let's stand for the Angelus, followed by the reception. The handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. We beseech thee, O Lord, pour thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, made by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Our sessional hymn 564, will your anchor hold.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us here at Christ the King in Richmond Park, where we plan our work and work our plan. Like, subscribe, and share our YouTube channel. Please see details below if you would like to join and support our wonderful ministry here at Christ the King. Have a blessed day.